Fight of the night, DePell in round one. Flyweight Muay Thai, Amir Nasseri and Taiko Naito. Naito from Japan, Nasseri representing Malaysia as well as Iran, grew up here in Kuala Lumpur. 3 3-minute rounds here in Muay Thai, the third of four fights on this lead card. And again, about an hour away from going exclusively on Prime Video for the main card and five fights, including three world titles on the line.
You see Naito early using that push kick and that inside leg kick to mitigate the distance right there, and he's quick the time that Nasseri is able, or trying to counter, that is.
Two elite strikers that like to go forward. Nice kick there by Naito into the body of Nasseri. Nearly a minute gone here in round one.
Yeah, this is the kind of style fight that Naito really likes. He likes to keep you at range. He likes to try to find his distance and his timing and just start touching you. Each little touch gives him a little bit better read on exactly what you're trying to do. This is Nasseri's opportunity to really start to change things up. He doesn't want to stand here and trade kicks with Naito like this.
Tried to straight left to Nasseri there, unable to land. Hasn't really landed anything yet, but Nasseri showing a lot in his arsenal here.
There's a little body kick that almost scored for him right there, but he's getting a good idea exactly what's coming after him from Naito. He's just got to push forward a little bit, start going to the body.
Both fighters in this opening round trying to find that range. A minute 20 left in the first round. Three 3-minute rounds. Flyweight Muay Thai division.
Yeah, Nasseri's getting a little bit wild with some of these strikes that he's throwing, especially with the kicks. He hasn't quite found his feet underneath him yet.
This is the same mistake that he made against Savas Michael, though, is that he started to get a little wild when he got impatient with his techniques landing.
Inside leg kick there from Naito, able to land that. Now tries a straight kick, and on the attack comes Nasseri. I just mentioned that heavy inside leg kick, and you can see the damage done on the inside of the leg of Amir Nasseri.
Good push kick by Naito.
And then the outside leg kick here, coming back for Nasseri.
We're just trading leg kicks at this point. Nice little combination there as Nasseri entered the pocket.
1-2-3 combo from Nasseri as he gets aggressive here. Tried the high kick and the spin, and he got caught when he spun and then throws Naito to the canvas.
That shin landed.
He got caught coming around, and Nasseri acknowledged the kick right there from Naito.
We said at the start, it's a fight between two elite strikers who always put on exciting fights, and they have shown that here in the first round. Good round one. So two phenomenal fights to start the night, and this one living up to the billing so far, Dragon.
Yeah, it's a lot of kicks. This first round was just basically these two trading. You go, I go, you go, I go. I'm gonna make you miss, I'm gonna make you pay. Nice little cut kick there attempted by Naito as he tried to go take out the support leg. Nasseri started to find his rhythm a little bit. He looked a little bit uneasy, but there was that beautiful high kick off of the spin. Naito was able to connect and wrap his shin around the back of the neck.
You see with these kicks that Naito is just a little tighter with the kicks. We talked about that karate style. You can see that he's just quicker to the punch slightly in that round.
Yeah, he's Nasseri is a little bit wider, a little bit more over-exaggerated, almost telegraphing his shots. He's really got to try to keep things tight. Go to those hands, start going to the body and the legs of Naito, because it's hard to hit the head of Taiki Naito.
The bell at round two. Crowd filing in here for this big night of fights in Kuala Lumpur inside the Axiata Arena. Again, Nasseri grew up right here in this city, so definitely has the crowd on his side against the Japanese-born Naito.
I like that. He caught the push kick and then went after the support leg and upended Nasseri. I really like the leg work of Taiki Naito.
Yeah, Nasseri needs to change his game plan up here. I wouldn't have started this round off with a push kick, because that's just taking you out of range. He needs to start closing this range, pushing Naito's back against that cage, like you mentioned earlier, Mitch.
Yeah, he doesn't want to stand in the center circle trading kicks with him. He's got to push forward, right? He comes forward a little bit, and then he gets back into kicking range. Yeah, now he needs to come forward, but he's got to be smart coming forward, because Naito is such a smooth counter striker. know there's a lot of emotion for Nesari. He's competing in front of a lot of friends and family here in KO. This means a lot for him. He kind of grew up, you know, around this stadium, you know, coming to sporting events here. So this means a lot. Another beautiful cut kick landed by Naito.
Yeah, Nesari had almost had Naito's back against the cage and then just allowed Naito to quarter turn out and come back around and take center circle again. And now he's back at this same game trading.
Naito been slicing in the first two rounds, that cut kick that you mentioned. Midway through the second round, midway through the fight, lunging in was Nesari. Got caught a little bit that time by Naito.
Oh, no, no, no. Yeah, he overextended, and he was. And it's hard to headhunt against Naito if you're not putting combinations together. If you throw just one big shot, he's got the eyes to be able to see, evade, and then touch.
Naito came to play here tonight. Nesari's trying to lock. There's that left hook to the head. Landed on Naito. See if Nesari can put something together here in the final minute of the second round. Outside leg kick, and then he comes with a body kick. Caught by Naito, who trades right back with his left hook. Straight right from Nesari, nothing doing. Is this about what you expected, Mitch, going in?
I expected a little bit more aggression coming from Nesari, and I also expected him to cut the angles a little bit. You can see how Naito kind of circles to his left a lot, and I expect Nesari to really start to cut that angle off, start throwing low kicks to really stop that lateral movement that comes from Naito, and start putting hand combinations together. But this is what I expected completely from Taiki Naito.
Final 10 seconds of round two. Flyweight Muay Thai, wild throw that time by Naito. Kicks it back, wild head kick attempt there from Nesari.
Yeah, you can see that he's just winding up big with those kicks. Naito was completely disappeared on him as that kick came. Not only did he lean back and evade it, but at the same time, he quarter turned, brought his back off the cage.
The movement has been phenomenal from Naito in the opening two rounds.
Yeah, this is how it started, right? He goes right after that push kick, and then Naito, being the veteran that he is, caught it, swept out the support leg. Look at this, it's beautiful. Boom, takes out the support leg, puts it on your butt. It just looks dominant to the judges. You know, it scores, it looks good, and it's also a little bit demoralizing to pick yourself up off the kick before.
So it's going down, so it's striking, so just concentrate on the head. If you think you can do it, go for it. Is it okay? Go ahead.
Good stuff in the corner of Naito. So what can Nesari do here, Rich, to turn the tide in the final round in a fight that, you know, clearly on the scorecards, he's down in?
Well, he started off with a push kick in that round, and that keeps range, but then he started closing the distance, which is what he needs to do. But he needs to be more systematic about the way that he's doing it, getting his head offline, because his head, as he's coming in, is just right in place for Naito to land those straight punches that we were talking about before that's been influenced by that karate style. You saw that he just ate a jab there on the way in.
He's throwing the feint, like he's changing stances and he's coming forward, but there's no answer. There's nothing after it, right?
10-point scoring system, how do you have it through two rounds?
I gotta give two rounds to Taiki Naito at this point. He's just doing a little bit more. He's touching, he's scoring, he's counter-striking.
Ready?
But
let's go.
Olivier Cost urges him on. Says a little bit more action here in the final round.
No.
So unofficial, but the Dragon has it 10-9 in favor of Naito of Japan.
Yeah, Nesari is gonna have to score a knockdown at this point if he wants to keep things in his favor on the judges' scorecards.
See the damage on the nose. Really bulking up and getting red there, the nose of Nesari as he comes in with a nice left.
This is exactly what he needs to be doing too, and making this fight ugly.
Nesari trying to get aggressive, salvage something inside the final 2 minutes. Mitch mentioned he needs a knockdown. He is certainly going for it, trying to walk down Naito in this third round.
You can almost see Nesari grimace before he throws a punch, right? Like he bites down on his mouthpiece and kind of and he kind of flexes before he's about to go, which is kind of a telegraph.
Yeah, it's all those are all tells, and that's the kind of things that Naito is reading. It's any little thing, a hand that comes back before it actually goes out, a grit of the teeth. These are the tells that lets your opponent know, like, hey, I'm coming. And it's microseconds that count in a fight.
Inside leg kick to the thigh, beautifully by Naito.
That was a body shot that landed. Even though Naito caught it, he still good head movement right there to counter with the left hook. I think Nesari needs another couple of rounds to really find his rhythm, because now he's starting to turn it on, but Naito's touching him as he's coming in.
Minute left here in round three. Obviously, Nasseri trying to take some chances here with the jab. Now stepping in, looking for a firefight in the final 50 seconds to do something here in a fight which he's down.
Nasseri's got to be careful reaching for that leg kick. You don't want to reach down and try to catch the leg kick. This isn't Muay Thai, you can't, or this isn't MMA where you can run somebody down for a takedown.
Uppercut, then a left hook from Nasseri as he comes alive in the final minute. Nasseri.
Anytime your opponent waves it off like that, you know that you have to tag him.
Nasseri with a big right, but he didn't land, and now they're in the clinch. 25 seconds in the fight. Knees coming in from Nasseri, and now throws to the canvas Naito.
His KO crowd is letting them know that they appreciate the effort by Nasseri as he's trying to go forward. Nice little body kick there. He turns. Got to be careful showing your back like that, though.
Final 10 seconds of this very entertaining fight here in Kuala Lumpur. And that's how it comes to a close. Talk about two guys trying to close the show, Rich Franklin.
I'll tell you, Nasseri was headhunting on that last punch that he threw there.
Mitch, you had Naito up on the scorecard after two. Nasseri with a huge sense of urgency, give him a lot of credit in the third round.
Yeah, he turned it up. I think he took the warning from Olivier Coste very seriously, and we started to see a lot more of what we expect from Amir Nasseri. Now, those kicks were caught, and a nice little answer there by Taiki Naito. Beautiful leg work. He really just scored a lot of points going to the legs, both inside and outside. Nice little combination, and that's what we needed from Amir, is to get out of the way and come back strong and really start to put the hand combinations together. You can see these guys are just two very exciting flyweights.
Tom Lau has the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Taiki.